If you've decided to buy a secondhand graphics card, one wrong move could mean throwing all your money down the drain. To make sure that doesn't happen, I'm going to cover everything you need to check before buying a used graphics card. So let's dive in. Let's say you've decided to buy a secondhand RTX 3070. If you're wondering, with so many used listings, which one should I choose? Let me explain. For RTX 3070s, you will see various models like the MSI Ventus, ASUS TUF, and EVGA XC3. These are called the AIB or add-in board partner models, and this can affect used prices. These brands take the base RTX 3070 GPU, add their own voltage regulator modules, VRMs, and coolings, and often tweak the factory clock speeds and the overall design before selling them. So while it's still an RTX 3070 at its core, it differs on these aspects. Your goal, of course, is to pick the best one for the price, regardless of the brand. For instance, imagine you found 5 different RTX 3070 graphics cards for the same price. Palette Jetstream, PNY XLR8, MSI Gaming X Trio, EVGA FTW3, and ASUS TUF. The easiest way to differentiate them is by looking at their cooling performance. I highly recommend checking out detailed reviews for this. Whether you're buying new or used, our goal is to weed out the poorly performing models. To do this, you can check out Tech PowerUp's reviews like I do. In these reviews, to assess cooling performance, focus on 3 key metrics: temperatures, noise, and fan speeds, or RPM. Even a quick glance at performance graphs can reveal the difference. While the PNY, EVGA, MSI, and ASUS cards might perform similarly, the Palette Jetstream lags considerably behind. So the Jetstream is not a good choice at this price range. So we'll take the Jetstream off the list. We're left with 4 options: MSI, EVGA, PNY, and ASUS. To choose between these 4, we need to take a look at the conditions of the cards. This takes us to our next crucial point. Over time, graphics cards can lose cooling performance due to how they're used, the environment they were in, and the maintenance they've received. This performance degradation may be caused by dust clogging the cooling block, dried out thermal paste and thermal pads, or even a potential hardware malfunction. Because of this, you must test the cards on the listings you're considering to buy. There are 2 essential programs you can use for this: FurMark and GPU-Z. FurMark stresses the GPU by placing it under a heavy, sustained load, while GPU-Z lets you monitor the card's vital stats during the test. First, ask the seller to run a 15-minute FurMark test and request a screenshot every 5 minutes. This is exactly how you should request this because, unfortunately, there are too many unreputable sellers out there. Even if the listing description claims good performance, you must verify it yourself. Here's what to look for in the screenshots or video they send. 1. Power fluctuation. This reading helps you identify if there's an issue with the card's power delivery. There should not be any fluctuations in power values. 2. Clock speeds. You need to make sure that there aren't any significant drops in the GPU core and memory clock speeds. If you see major drops in these values, it could mean 2 things. First, the card might be thermal throttling, which means that it might be lowering its clock speeds to bring the temperatures down in order to protect itself from damage. Second, there could be an issue with the power delivery system. Keep in mind, these types of issues are usually caused by the cooling. 3. The temperatures and the RPM. This is the most important one of them all. Graphics card temperatures are measured under 3 main categories: GPU hotspot temperature, GPU core temperature, and memory temperature. Make sure that these values are not getting higher than necessary. After that, check the RPM as well. If it's spinning much faster than normal, it indicates that the cooling is either inadequate or poorly maintained. If you're asking how hot should a graphics card be, there's no single answer because not all graphics cards operate at the same temperature. For example, an RTX 3070 and an RTX 4070 will have different typical operating temperatures. In fact, not even the temperatures of an ASUS ROG Strix RTX 3070 and an MSI Ventus RTX 3070 might be the same. Therefore, you need to research the typical operating temperatures and fan speeds for the specific model you're interested in when it's brand new. You can find this baseline data along with expected clock speeds by watching review videos and performance tests on YouTube. Generally, the closer the used card's temperatures and fan speeds are to its brand new performance, the better. There is one more important thing you need to pay attention to. But first, let me tell you about ChatLLM. With so many AI models specializing at different tasks, choosing the right one can be tricky. ChatLLM makes this process easy with RouteLLM, which routes your request to the best LLM for your prompt. But it's not just about language models. ChatLLM also supports image and video generation using multiple models. I personally use it to create thumbnails. Just describe what you have in mind and watch as ChatLLM makes your idea happen. Thanks to its many features, it also makes working with documents way easier. You can chat with PDFs, ask questions, summarize and create notes or quizzes. If you're a developer, ChatLLM has you covered too. It offers features like code-based Q&A and CodeLLM, a VS Code-based editor included at no extra cost. The Humanize feature rewrites AI-generated content to sound more natural and pass most AI detectors. And the most powerful feature of them all, Deep Agent can help you complete any complex task. Create PowerPoint slideshows, websites, custom AI chatbots, and do way, way more. All of this starts at just $10 per user per month, giving you access to multiple top-tier LLMs, often for less than the price of just one elsewhere. Visit chatllm.abacus.ai or click the link in the description to get started today. Now back to the video. Remember, a used card that hasn't been maintained can never produce the same temperatures and performance values as a brand new card. Why? Because thermal pads and pastes lose their effectiveness over time, and heat sinks get clogged with dust. Without maintenance, temperatures will inevitably continue to climb. Getting back to our buying scenario. Let's say the sellers of the ASUS, PNY, EVGA, and MSI cards have all run the 15-minute FurMark test as requested and sent you the results. You then pull up your review sources and start comparing their temperatures, fan speeds, and power draw figures against the baseline for new cards. Even though the MSI and ASUS cards have high temperatures and high fan speeds, there aren't any power fluctuations, so they are still viable options. The PNY doesn't have any fluctuations in power either, but the temperatures and the fan speeds are very high. This can be solved by replacing the thermal paste and thermal pad, but this means higher costs and more work for you, so we can eliminate the PNY card. Now let's look at the EVGA 3070. Unfortunately, the situation here is pretty bad. The temperatures are very high, fan speeds are abnormally high, there are fluctuations in power, and worst of all, the clock speed goes down during testing. Because of this, you definitely need to stay away from this card. There is a chance that the card just might be not taken care of, but a more critical and often feared possibility with used cards comes into play. A history of cryptocurrency mining. Mining, especially prevalent between 2020 and 2022, was an intense and continuous computational process being performed by graphics cards. During this period, thousands of graphics cards were operated at 100% load for months or sometimes even years. And when I say thousands here, I'm really not exaggerating it. Back then, there weren't any GPUs left on the market due to crypto miners, so you had to be really lucky to be able to buy a graphics card. Towards the end of 2022, with the end of Ethereum mining, this GPU shortage gradually eased. Although the market could finally breathe a little, the negative effects of that era linger even today. Thousands of graphics cards bought between 2020 and 2022 and used for mining for months or even years were suddenly offloaded onto the used market as they were no longer profitable for that purpose. Consequently, a huge portion of used graphics card listings became saturated with these old, often poorly maintained ex-mining cards. And as you can guess, even though not all, most of these cards were faulty, and it didn't make sense to buy these. Even today, even though the mining era has come to a close, some cards that were used for mining are being sold under the false claim of never mined on. So if you're wondering, how can I tell if a card was used for mining? The answer is, you can't. If an ex-mining card had maintenance done on it, it's very hard to tell from the outside. This is why cards that were heavily mined on, particularly from the RTX 30 series, RX 6000 series, and even some older generations, carry a higher risk in the used market. But don't worry, there are some precautions you can take. One of the most reliable methods is to check the purchase date on the receipt. If the seller bought the card after September 2022, you don't need to worry as mining ended around then. Another thing to check is whether the model name includes LHR. Some cards were manufactured with this firmware level limiter on mining. But as time went on, modders found a way to get around this lock, and it became possible for LHR cards to be used for mining purposes. So the lock effectively failed to do its job. As a result, we can't tell for certain if a LHR card was used in mining or not. But at least the chance of it ever being used for mining is a bit lower. The last and the most optimistic method is trusting the seller and the test results they provide. Some people who did mining could have done it for a short amount of time, like just a few weeks or a month before giving up. If the test results are solid, and if the temperatures and the fan speeds are at a reasonable range, and if there aren't any better options, these cards can be bought. Now let's continue where we left off. We have two strong candidates remaining, the MSI and the ASUS TUF. If you recall, we eliminated the EVGA due to its likely mining history, and we eliminated the PNY because it was very poorly maintained. The next step is the last step, the final comparison and the decision-making process. There are 2 points you can pay close attention to. 1. Warranty and other extras. Most RTX 3070s are no longer within their warranty period, so you shouldn't expect much here, but there's still some details to check. The box and the box contents, the receipt information, and previous maintenance or servicing done by the seller. 2. Trade offers and bargaining. Some sellers are open to trade offers. If you have an older graphics card and can upgrade to a better model by adding a reasonable amount of cash, this could be a significant advantage. I definitely recommend making an offer. It can't hurt to try. If these factors I've listed here are the same for both graphics cards, try to bargain. Let's say both cards are listed at the same price, for example, $285. Their conditions are comparable and they have similar warranties and box content. What you need to do here is to pick the seller that provides bigger discounts. The more discounts you get, the better it is. Now, there is one more thing I want to talk about. For this, let's go over another scenario. Let's say you're looking for a used RTX 3070 again. The prices on the market are generally between $280 and $320, but in one listing, you see the ASUS ROG 3070 listed for just $220. The price is incredibly low, making you skeptical, and rightly so. But here's the deal. Some users don't know much about graphics cards and might assume that high operating temperatures automatically mean the card is broken. So, they can sell cards that just need some maintenance for lower prices, as they think the card is faulty. So, the card you found could just be overheating due to a lack of maintenance, and the seller might just be trying to get it off their hands as soon as possible. You check the receipt and see it was purchased in December 2022, making it unlikely it was used for mining. Furthermore, after running a 15-minute Furmark test, you confirm that the overheating issue is indeed due to a lack of maintenance. In this situation, if you're a bit confident in your DIY skills, you could buy that card, perform the maintenance yourself, and end up with a great graphics card at a very affordable price. But of course, graphics card maintenance might not be easy for everyone, because it requires you to completely take the card apart. But don't worry, you can easily learn how to clean a graphics card thanks to guide videos on YouTube. Cleaning dust out of the cooling block is the easiest part. The most difficult and crucial part is the thermal pad, or the thermal paste replacement. You absolutely must find the right thermal pad dimensions for the GPU you have. Otherwise, the pad may be unable to provide the right contact with the area that heats, and this can lead to temperature issues. I strongly recommend taking a look at technical forums, such as Reddit, because there might be technical details you might be unaware of. For example, just the dimensions matching up is not enough when you're replacing the thermal pad. If the pad you're using is either too soft or too hard, you might experience contact issues due to the expansion caused by the temperature difference. Because of this, it is very important that you receive help from someone who has worked on your card before. This way, you can get clear and accurate information on exactly which type of pads you should buy. So, what's your experience on this topic? Have you ever bought a secondhand graphics card? And if you did you run into any issues? Don't forget to comment your stories down below. Your experiences could be very helpful for others looking to buy a used GPU. All right, let's wrap up the video. If you liked the video, don't forget to hit the like button. If not, feel free to dislike. Stay mysterious until the next video. Take care and bye.